Hello students, welcome back to Relief Tutorials. In the previous lecture we have discussed about solutions, true solution, suspension and colloidal solution, the types of mixtures. Now the next topic is about separation of components of mixture. How we can separate the components of mixture? See, the separation methods, there are different separation methods are available. Those methods are totally physical process, as we studied earlier, that components of mixtures can be easily separated by the physical processes. Homogeneous or heterogeneous, whatever the type of mixtures we are having, we have some and some process to separate them. It depends on the characteristics of the components which are mixed up. By knowing the characteristics of those components, selection of method can be done. For example, two components, two substances mixed up, and in that two substances, let us say A and B are the two substances got mixed up, and if out of these two one of them is volatile, means the substance which can be easily converted into gaseous state from its liquid state, means a substance which can easily get evaporate, that substance are called as volatile substance. Means if one of the liquid and solid got mixed up, and liquid is said to be volatile, means liquid can be easily get evaporate, then that substance, means that liquid can be easily get separated. The first process is the evaporation process. Evaporation process is only used when one of the component of mixture is volatile. Again, what do you mean by volatile substance? The substance which can easily converted from its liquid state to gaseous state, means easily get evaporate. So that substance can be easily get separated through this process of evaporation. Let us say one of the example from your textbook, let us say I have ink. Do you know ink is a mixture of water plus colored component called as dye? So the mixture of water and dye is called as ink. Water is liquid state substance, dye is a solid state substance which is dissolved in water. So this water is volatile. So this can be separated using evaporation method. So how can we separate water from ink? Consider this is one of the beaker. Water is filled in that. One of the watch glass is placed over it. And here is the ink. Ink is a mixture of water and dye. Now if you heat this, if you are heating this, the temperature of water gradually increases. So this water boils And due to vapors, the watch glass also get heated. And in these we have ink, which is a mixture of water and dye. So due to gradual heating of ink, water evaporates. And after some time, there is only dye left in the watch glass. For your kind information, dye particles is also the mixture of two or three colored components. For example, pink dye, magenta, cyan, such type of dyes are made up of two or three colored components. So it is also one type of mixture, and that is dissolved in water. But here we are just separating water. We are not going to decompose dye into their components. That is why the direct heating is avoided. Maybe the question in your mind that why don't we heat this ink directly? Why we are using this water and why we are heating this watch glass with the help of vapors? Because we don't want to decompose this dye particle into its components. No, we just want to separate water from dye. We want dye particle as it is. Later on, we will have one more method to separate all these components. But right now, we are not going towards that. So, if you make the ink directly heating, if you heat this ink directly, water evaporate, yes, as well as the dye particles also get decomposed. So, we don't want that. We just want to separate water from ink. So we are using the gradual heating of this watch glass. So one of the question is there in your textbooks, and I think that why direct heating of ink is avoided? Because due to direct heating, water evaporates as well as dye particles also get decomposed, and we don't want that dye particles to get decomposed. That's why we are using the gradual heating. So after some time, what will be left in the watch glass? Only the dye particles. Water evaporates, dye particle left in the watch glass. In this way, water gets separated from dye. And one more famous example, consider here is the glass of water. We have dissolved common salt in that. So if this is the solution of NaCl plus water, and if you keep this glass in the open atmosphere, then what happened? Due to sunlight, water gradually gets evaporate and only salt left in the glass. Water plus sugar, water plus salt, water plus dye, water plus something. So if one of the substance in the mixture is volatile, then we can use the separation method called evaporation. Is that clear? Second method is centrifugation method. Centrifugation method. This centrifugation method is used to separate colloid particles. From mixture. In the last lecture, we have discussed about the colloidal solutions. The size of these particles are neither too big nor too large. They cannot be seen directly with the naked eyes, but they are present. So we can separate them. After all, they are the solid particles. After all, they are the small sized solid particles. So consider this is one of the colloidal solution taken in the test tube. This is one of the colloidal solution in which the colloid particles are present. But these colloid particles cannot be seen directly with the naked eyes. Okay, so what is the simple process? You can consider one of the churning machine or the spinning machine, we can say. Consider this is one of the spinning machine. Here is the test tube holder. Okay, now when this machine starts revolving, rotating, spin. When this machine gets spin, the test tube becomes like this. Seems to be goes away. So when it is continuously spinning, the solid particles present are forced towards the bottom. The solid particles present are forced towards the bottom, away from the center. This is the center of rotation. From here the rotation is going on. So this is the center of rotation. The test tube becomes slanted like this, tilted like this. Okay, so the whatever the colloidal solution you have placed in that, the solid particles will be forced towards, let me draw the bigger diagram for you. When the test tube is rotating, test tube becomes like this. So the liquid which is present in these, having the colloidal particles, are going to force towards the bottom. Force towards the bottom means, can you see, it is away from the center. One of the force acting on this particle, and that force is called as centrifugal force. Centrifugal means away from center. Centrifugal means away from center. So one of the force acting on the solid particles away from the center, that is why this force is called as centrifugal force. So with the help of the centrifugal force, solid particles, solid colloid particles which is present in the solution, in the mixture, are forced towards the bottom and they are collected at the bottom of the test tube. So when you stop spinning, you will see the test tube becomes like this, steady one, and in that you will have solid particles at the bottom. So this way, liquid and solid get separated. These are the colloid particles. This process, that is why called as centrifugation. Centrifugation means forcing the particle away from the center. Forcing the heavy particle away from the center. I have one diagram to show. See, this is one of the churning machine, spinning machine. Here the test tubes are, revolving. So the test tube, four test tubes are here, they are revolving, and they are, and the particle, colloid particle which are present, are forced towards the bottom, away from the center. This is the center of the revolution, and the particles are forced away from the center. So that is what is called as centrifugation process, separation of colloidal particles from the solution. During the discussion of colloidal particles, we have discussed that colloid particles can be, cannot be separated by the filtration process, but they can be separated by centrifugation method. These method, do you know our blood? Blood is a mixture of plasma plus RBCs, WBCs and platelets. So when blood is revolved in this test tube, these particles, RBCs, WBCs, blood platelets, these are the colloid side particles. So these are forced towards the bottom. So after spinning for some time, we will have this type of appearance in the test tube, in the blood. On the top, that is plasma, then platelets, then red blood cells, and then we have WBCs, because WBCs will be at the bottom because they are largest in size. Over there, there will be the layer of RBCs, and over there, there is a layer of platelets, and over there, there is a layer of plasma. In the same way, urine also can be differentiated into their components. So this centrifugation, see, we have uses. This centrifugation process is used टू डायग्नोज ब्लड एंड यूरिन इन द लेबोरेटरी. हैव यू सीन द वर्किंग ऑफ वॉशिंग मशीन? सो वॉशिंग मशीन ऑल्सो स्पिन द क्लोथ्स एंड ड्यू टू दैट व्हाट हैपेंस, द हैवी पार्टिकल्स ऑफ वॉटर आर फोर्स्ड अवे. सो वॉटर विल बी गेट सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम क्लोथ्स. हैव यू सीन द सेपरेशन ऑफ बटर फ्रॉम बटर मिल्क? सेम लॉजिक कैन बी यूज देयर. वी कैन सेपरेट बटर फ्रॉम क्रीम. सो दिस आर द यूजेस ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगेशन प्रोसेस. Is that clear? Now, one more method. See, third method is separation by separating funnel. Separation by separating funnel. This method is used when two or more immiscible liquids mixed up. Or we can say this method is used to separate two or more immiscible liquids. It's very easy to understand. For example, water plus kerosene. Water plus kerosene. You know that water is heavier than the kerosene. So when you try to mix them in a beaker, let us say this is one of the beaker, and you want to mix water and kerosene. So when you try to mix them, what you will see? You will see kerosene on the top and water at the bottom. Actually, these two is not mixed up, actually, you can say, because of the difference in their densities. There is a quite difference in their densities. Water is quite denser as compared to kerosene. So when you try to mix them, water will be at the bottom and kerosene will be on the top of the mixture. So we have such type of separating funnel. Here is a stopcock. First you close this tap for some time. Now pour this mixture. So you will have kerosene on the top and water at the bottom. Now place a beaker. Make this stopcock on. So gradually water starts to pour here in the beaker. As you see that the whole water comes here, stop the cock for some time. Replace the beaker and kerosene can be separated. Here is the kerosene. Here was the water. This method is used to separate oil from water taken out from the earth, the petroleum oil. The petroleum oil, when we take out from the earth, that is a mixture of water and oil. So this way water and oil can be separated. Again, in that case, water is heavier and oil is light in weight. One more industrial use is there. During the extraction of iron from their ore in the furnace, let me give you some hint. Consider this is one of the furnace which is used to extract iron from its ore. See, iron is not obtained in the pure form from the earth. We have to make them separate. So here is the iron layer in the furnace. There is iron, molten iron is collected here in the liquid state, and there will be the slag. Slag means lightweight, lightweight liquid. So there is a mixture of molten state, means liquid state of iron, and slag. So we can separate these two, because having the vast difference in their densities, this is quite light in weight, slag, but Fe is quite heavier in the molten state also. So you can separate them using the separating funnel method. So two uses are there: separating oil from water and separating iron from the slag. So this is the third process. Fourth process is sublimation process. The name itself suggests you. We know the sublimation process, when the substance directly converts from solid to gas. So this method is used to separate solid volatile substance. Solid volatile substance is also called as sublime. Solid volatile means the substance directly converts from solid to gases. So when you want to separate a solid volatile substance from the mixture, we can use sublimation process. We have some examples of sublimes. Sublimes means the substance possess sublimating property. For example, camphor. Kapoor we say. Ammonium chloride. Naphthalene balls. Have you seen these naphthalene balls? White colored tablets which we used in our almaris, which we place these type of tablets along with the clothes to get rid of the attack of moths on our clothes. So naphthalene balls, white colored tablets. Iodine is also one of the sublime. Anthracene. These are some names of sublimes: camphor, ammonium chloride, naphthalene balls, iodine, anthracene. These are some names of such type of substance which actually exist in solid state, but on heating they directly convert from solid to gas. One of the activities given in your textbook, that consider you have a mixture of NaCl and ammonium chloride. Sodium chloride and ammonium chloride. You have a mixture of sodium chloride plus ammonium chloride. NaCl plus NH4Cl. Sodium chloride and NH4Cl means ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride is one of the sublime. So you have a mixture of one solid volatile substance and one regular solid. Okay, so this is one of the watch glass. You have a mixture of sodium chloride and ammonium chloride. Place one of the funnel in the inverted position. Close this mouth by one of the cotton cloth or paper. Now heat this solution. So due to heating, what happens? The sublime NH4Cl starts to evaporate directly. Now these vapors of NH4Cl collides with the wall of the funnel and again that vapor solidifies. So again that vapor gets solidified. And you will see the layer of ammonium chloride on the inner walls of these inverted funnel. So after some time you will have only NaCl left in this main portion of watch glass, and the whole NH4Cl is collected on the inner wall of this inverted funnel, and that we can later on easily remove. So this way these two substances get separated. So this is nothing but the sublimation process. Is that clear? So these are the four different methods we have seen today. The first method was evaporation method. Evaporation method is used to separate one of the liquid volatile substance present in the mixture. Second one was centrifugation method. It is used to separate colloid particles from the mixture. We have some uses also. Third method was easy method of separating funnel method when two immiscible liquids got mixed up. Immiscible liquids means they are not going to mix with each other because of the vast difference in their densities. Okay, and the fourth method was sublimation, that if one of the sublime got mixed up. Sublime means solid volatile substance. Okay, we have still some more methods, but that we will see in the next session. Keep practicing, make notes. Thank you. Best of luck.